Students, so today's lecture is about introduction to the brainstem and the cranial nerve nuclei which lie in the brainstem. Brainstem is the part of the brain which connects the narrow spinal cord with the expanded forebrain, and this consists of three parts. The midbrain, pons and medulla. So all of these three structures, they are present in the cranial fossa. So these are the cerebral hemispheres, these are the cerebellar hemispheres, and this is the brainstem. And this brainstem is continuous with the spinal cord below. So this is the medulla oblongata, then pons, and then midbrain. So again, this is the diagrammatic picture which shows the, this is the medulla oblongata shown in the blue one. And you can see here the external features. There are some features present externally in the medulla oblongata, and these are thread-like structures which are coming out. These are the cranial nerves. This is the pons shown in the pink one. And this is the midbrain shown in the green one. This is the ventral aspect of the brain stem. What are the functions of brain stem? It serves as a conduit for ascending tracts and descending tracts connecting the spinal cord to the different parts of the higher centers in the forebrain. And they have got important reflex centers present, like respiratory, cardiovascular, and control of consciousness. The third important function is the presence of cranial nerve nuclei from 3rd to 12th. In them, we will study the various parts, that is the medulla oblongata, the pons, and the midbrain. And in these structures, we will study the various ascending and descending tracts which are coming from the spinal cord or from the higher centers, going to the spinal cord from the higher centers, and the cranial nerve nuclei which are present, along with other nuclei which are present in the brainstem. So, in order to study the cranial nerves and their nuclei, a cranial nerve nuclei is a group of cells or neurons which are present in the gray matter which participate in formation of cranial nerve. Now, these are equivalent to the dorsal root ganglia of spinal nerves and to the anterior horn cells of the spinal nerves. Now, each nuclei have only one single function. We will study the nuclei in the brainstem, and we will see that each nuclei will have a single one function. That is, either it is sensory or it is motor. A cranial nerve which have one function is connected to one nuclei that serve that function. For example, hypoglossal nerve supplying to the muscles of the tongue are motor. This is a motor nerve, and it is connected to only one single nuclei, that is the hypoglossal nuclei. A cranial nerve which have many functions is connected to a number of nuclei, the number of its function equal to the number of its functions, and each nuclei also served only one function again. So if it is a mixed nerve, so it has got a motor nuclei or a sensory nuclei. And then also the sensory nuclei, it can be special or it can be general. So there is also shared nuclei. That is, the two or more cranial nerves, they can share one nuclei. So this is a picture showing the cranial nerves. That is, number one is the olfactory. Number two is the optic. Number three is the oculomotor. Number four is the trochlear. Number 5 is the trigeminal. Number 6 is the abducens. Number 7 is the facial. Number 8 is the glossopharyngeal, vestibulocochlear. And this is number 9. This is glossopharyngeal. And number 10 is the vagus. Then it is the vagus. And number 11 is the accessory. And number 12 is the hypoglossal. Now these are the various cranial nerves. 1 and 2, cranial nerve 1 and 2, their neurons are not present in the brainstem. Rest of the cranial nerves have nuclei in the brainstem. When we will study, you will be knowing them when we will study the sections of the brainstem. Now the functional components of the cranial nerves. There are seven functional components to which the fibers of a cranial nerve may belong. We will see what kind of functional components are these and what are the nuclei associated with it and what function they do. So it will be easy to understand the nuclei which are present in the at various levels of the brainstem. Now each functional component has its own nuclei of origin. In the case of efferent fibers, or of termination in case of afferent fibers. In the embryo, the nuclei related to the various components are arranged in vertical rows or columns in a definite sequence in gray matter related to the floor of the fourth ventricle. We will see it later on. Now, the afferent sensory neurons. So they have got somatic and visceral. So first of all, is division of these nuclei is on the basis of their function, that is motor or sensory. So we are taking first of all the sensory part. Okay, in sensory, we have got two components, that is the somatic related to body wall and visceral related to viscera. Now, in somatic, we have got two components, that is the general and the special. General and the special. And in visceral, also we have got general and special. So, there are four sensory components, that is the general, somatic, afferent. General somatic afferent. Number one is general somatic afferent. If you like this, general somatic afferent. First component is the general somatic afferent. It carries general somatic senses. This is the sense of touch, pain, temperature, vibration, pressure, and proprioceptive senses from the muscles and joints. Number two component is the special somatic afferent. Special somatic afferent. Special somatic afferent. Number two is special somatic afferent. Special somatic afferent. It carries special senses of vision, hearing, and equilibrium. That is from the eye and ear. Number three is the general visceral afferents. General visceral afferent. It carries general senses from the visceras. And then is the special visceral afferent. Special visceral afferent. They carry special senses of smell and taste from the nose and tongue. So these are the sensory components of the cranial nerves. And we will see that the cranial nerves have got nuclei which are associated with general somatic afferents, general visceral afferents, special somatic afferents, and special visceral afferents. So cranial nerves with afferent or sensory fibers are the cranial nerve 1, 2, 5, 7, 8, 9 and 10. That is olfactory, optic. These are purely sensory nerves, and also the vestibulocochlear, that is 8th cranial nerve. These are pure sensory. And mixed nerves are the cranial nerve 5, that is trigeminal, 7th, that is facial, 9th, that is glossopharyngeal, and 10th, that is vagus. These are mixed nerves. And cranial nerve 1, 2, 7, 8, 9, 10, they carry special sense fibers. That is the, this is special somatic afferent and special visceral afferent. Now the efferent or motor fibers, they have again got a somatic component and a visceral component. Now this somatic component, which is going to the body wall, again has got two types, general and special. And the visceral component have got also the general and the special going to viscera. Now this component is absent here in the efferent or motor. We do not have any special somatic efferent fibers. So number one is the general somatic efferent fibers. General somatic efferent fibers. General somatic efferent fibers, which are supplying the skeletal muscles of somatic or myotome region. Then the second component is the general visceral efferent. General visceral efferents, they supply smooth muscles, cardiac muscle, muscles and the secretomotor fibers to the glands. Number three component is the special visceral efferent. Special visceral efferent. Special visceral efferent fibers supply skeletal muscles of visceral, branchial or pharyngeal arch region. So cranial nerves with efferent or motor fibers are the cranial nerve 3rd, that is oculomotor, trochlear, trigeminal, abducens, facial, glossopharyngeal, vagus, accessory and hypoglossal. And in these, the pure motor nerve is the oculomotor, trochlear, abducens, accessory and the hypoglossal. While mixed one is the trigeminal, facial, glossopharyngeal and vagus nerve. So cranial nerve 3rd, 7th, 9th and 10th, they carry parasympathetic fibers. Showing the letter symbols commonly used to indicate the functional components of each cranial nerve. And we have the afferent, first of all, the afferent component. Afferent component, general somatic afferent, they carry general sensations and the symbol is GSA. Special somatic afferent, they carry the hearing, balance and vision, SSA. General visceral efferent, afferent, general visceral afferent. First of all, we have the general somatic afferent, then special somatic afferent, then general visceral afferent. It carries information from the viscera. So GVA. Then special visceral afferent carry the sense of smell and taste, SVA. Then the efferent fibers. General somatic efferent carry somatic, they carry information to the somatic striated muscles, GSE. And then general visceral efferent, they carry the information to the glands and smooth muscles and the cardiac muscles, GVA, GVE. And special visceral efferent, branchial arch striated muscles, SVE. So these are the various cranial nerve nuclei which are present in the parts of the brainstem. And this part is the open part of the medulla, and this is the fourth ventricle, and the cranial nerve nuclei are lying in the floor of the fourth ventricle, and they are arranged in vertical rows or columns in the floor of the fourth ventricle. Now, if you have to remember the sequence, each half of the floor of the ventricle is divided into medial part and a lateral part. So this is the medial part and this is the lateral part. Efferent nuclei lie in the medial part. Efferent nuclei, they lie in the medial part called the basal lamina, and afferent nuclei lie in the lateral part called the alar lamina. In each part, visceral nuclei, medial or lateral, visceral nuclei lie nearer the sulcus limitans than the somatic nuclei. So this is the sulcus limitans, which is dividing the two alar and basal plate, and this is the sulcus limitans. And the visceral nuclei, they lie close to the sulcus limitans than the somatic nuclei. Within each category, visceral efferents and somatic efferents, etc., the general nuclei lie nearer the sulcus limitans than the special nuclei. So that the special nuclei, they lie, in case of efferent, it lies more medially, and in case of afferent, it lies more laterally towards the outside. As the development proceeds, parts of these columns disappear so that each of them no longer extend the whole length of the brainstem, but is represented by one or more discrete nuclei. Now, these nuclei are shown here in this picture, the picture below. Some nuclei retain their original positions in relation to the floor of the fourth ventricle, but some others migrate deeper into the brainstem. The position of the nuclei relative to the posterior surface of the brainstem now, these are the position of the nuclei present in the posterior surface of the brainstem. Various parts of the brainstem, and you can see here that they are present in the form of columns or vertical rows. You can see various nuclei. These are the collection of neurons known as nuclei, and they extend to the various parts of the brain stem. You can see here, lying at various levels and extending to the various parts of the brain stem.